Hey guys, it's Coach Austin here from UCAPA CrossFit. We're going to start this Tuesday off with a quote. The quote is, "All hard work leads to profit, but mere talk leads to poverty," which is a proverb. It's a weird time right now. You don't have the same accountability that you would in a classroom per se. But what that means is it's all the more important for us to work as hard as we can and try to strive for the profit on the other side. All right, guys, Tuesday's warm-up is going to be 3 rounds with 4 separate movements. The first one is going to be 10 reps of a lunge. You should be a little bit more familiar with the lunge from yesterday. The second one is going to be 5 push-ups. Third one is going to be a 30-second IT band stretch. And the fourth one is going to be 10 cherry pickers. All right, the first of the 4 movements is going to be a lunge. This will be stationary just for the warm-up. It's going to be 10 reps. You're going to take a step forward or backwards until your back knee touches the ground or your front knee touches the ground. You want to keep your front leg at a 90-degree angle. It's important to not let your knee pass your toe, just like that. So 10 total reps, 5 each side. The second movement is going to be push-ups. So he's going to start in a plank position just like this, go all the way down to his chest touches the ground, and then he's going to lock out at the top again. If this is a little too difficult for you to do, you can go ahead and put your knees on the ground and then try to do push-ups this way. And even if it is a little bit more too difficult for you doing this, you could do them to a chair, to the wall, or something of that nature. The third movement is going to be the IT band stretch. You're going to hold this for 30 seconds. So your back leg extended behind you, your front leg at the side of your foot, near the center of your chest, pushing your knee outwards. You should feel a stretch from your knee to your hip on the IT band on the outside of the quad. So you're going to hold 30 seconds on each side. The next one is going to be cherry pickers. So 10 reps of cherry pickers. So he's going to go from one side to the other, stop in the middle. There's one, there's two, just like that. And if you wanted to, you can alternate directions and make sure you're going to go both ways. So nice and good warm up for Tuesday. 3 rounds of all that. For today's strength portion, we have 3 sets of 3 separate movements. We're going to start with 30 seconds of a Cossack squat, followed by 30 seconds of shoulder taps, followed by 30 seconds of glute bridges, and then a rest after each round. All right, so you want all 3 of those movements to be consecutive, 30 seconds in a row for each. It's going to be tough to get through all 90 seconds of it, but make sure you're going through all 3 in a row and then rest as much as you need in between the 3 sets. So the first movement of today's strength portion, the Cossack squat for 30 seconds. So you're going to start with a wide base just like this, and you're going to shift back and forth just like this. It's a really good hip opener. You notice how he's trying to keep his balance as best as he can. This is a pretty advanced movement, so make sure you're going slow and in control. It's not meant to be done at a fast pace while you're going through this. The second movement is going to be a plank shoulder tap. So he's going to go into the top of a push-up position just like this. And then what he's going to do is he's going to touch his shoulder with the opposite hand. Just like that. So there's one, touch the shoulder with the opposite hand. There's two, back and forth for 30 seconds. All right. The third movement here is going to be a glute bridge. So he's going to start on his back. His feet are going to be on the floor, the soles of his shoes on the floor. And then he's going to press upwards with his hips and then squeeze his glutes and hamstrings at the top and then go back and forth. Again, not meant to be a movement that's supposed to be fast. It's meant to be a slow kind of burning movement. After those 3 movements, you're going to rest as much as you need and then 3 sets, 30 seconds each movement. All right, guys, for Tuesday's workout, we have 3 sets of 2 separate movements separated by 15 seconds of rest. So 30 seconds of work, 15 seconds of rest, 30 seconds of work, 15 seconds of rest, 3 times through. The first movement is going to be a jumping squat, and the second movement is going to be a flutter kick. So the jumping squats, similar to an air squat, you're gonna send your hips back down below parallel, and then small jump at the top, just like this. Enough to slide a credit card underneath your feet. It doesn't need to be super high jump, but it does need to be done with intensity. So this will be a movement that you're going at a fast pace with. The second movement is a flutter kick, a little bit of an intense ab core strengthening movement. So notice how his hands are at his sides. He's fluttering his feet back and forth, trying to stabilize and really brace his core. If this gets to be too challenging, another thing you can do is you can put your hands beneath your lower back, just like this, and that helps to stabilize for your flutter kicks as well. All right, guys, Tuesday's workout. So your workout is 3 rounds of 30 seconds of work and 15 seconds of rest of 2 separate movements. The first movement is going to be a jumping air squat, and the second movement is going to be a flutter kick. All right, so you guys have 3 rounds with 15 seconds rest in the middle. For the purpose of the demo, what we're gonna have is we're gonna have 1 round of a 10 second window of jumping air squats followed by 5 second rest, and then a 10 second window of flutter kicks, just to show you guys what it would look like to be doing these two movements back to back. All right, so ready, 3, 2, 1, go. So these are jumping air squats, guys. All right, and then 3, 2, 1, rest. And then next will be flutter kicks. Ready? 3, 2, 1, go! Flutter kicks. All right, good job, guys. So keep in mind that your workout is gonna be 30 second windows and a 15 second rest, as opposed to the 10 second window and a 5 second rest we just did there. For Tuesday's cash out or challenge, we're gonna have 4 separate 45 second planks. The first one's gonna be a prone plank on your palms. The second one is gonna be a Superman plank. And then we're gonna do a side plank on each side. So the prone plank on your palms, you're just gonna come to the top of a push-up position and hold 45 seconds there. The Superman is a little bit more of an advanced movement. You're going to be on your stomachs just like this, and then try to get your hands and your feet off the ground just like that. Hold for 45 seconds. The next one's going to be a side plank from your elbow. All right. Holding that position, trying not to let your hips dip low, trying to hold that plank position. And then you can do 45 seconds on each side just like that. All right, guys, Tuesday's cash out. Don't forget all the planking that we have. We have the prone plank from the palms. We have the Superman plank, and then a plank from each elbow, 45 seconds each. All right, so don't forget to do that as your cash out. Good job on Tuesday's workout. See you Wednesday.